Dagsnytt klokken 12.
Politiet Stavanger pågrep i går kveld 4 mennesker mistenkt for å drive med ulovlige radiosendinger. Sendingene som pågikk i hele går forstyrret blant annet instrumentene på skolen.
Ja, hei, og velkommen til Kaffebloggen Ekstra. Ja, jeg har byttet ut kaffen med litt øl, akkurat nå i solen av gangen. Det vil si den en stund til solen går ned, da, men han går bakom noen trær, så jeg har sådde nytt solen og bare en enkel boks øl på trappen. Og der har jeg sett på dagens kaffeblogg, og det var jo en litt rar opplevelse. For det første, helt til begynner med, når det sånn tåkebilder, der skulle jeg lagt på en voiceover hvor jeg ønskte velkommen til kaffebloggen og fortalte hva som jeg skulle se fremover. Altså klippene ifra Ove, og ifra Endre, og ifra Jan Sverre, og ifra Gabriel. Og etter Gabriel, da satt jeg her på kjøkkenet og pratet litt. Jeg talte litt om en nyhetssak som var i dag, men det skal jeg ikke gjøre nå om igjen. Men jeg må nesten si litt om dette her med slag. Jeg fortalte litt om en kamerat av meg som fikk slag for et års tid siden, og som nå har kommet seg ganske godt. Og han har jo da fulgt sånn vanlig medisinsk behandling for slag, og går på blodtrykksreduserende medisin og blodfortynnende medisin. Og jeg også går jo på det samme, og vi så denne her videoen med han kiropraktoren, og jeg fikk lyst til å dele han, men med advarsel, for han er jo veldig kontroversiell. Altså, jeg fortsetter å bruke mine piller, kameraten min fortsetter å bruke sine piller, og jeg har en kamerat i Norge også, og er litt skeptisk til piller, men jeg trenger disse pillene. Eller gjør meg. Det var liksom det som jeg stilte som spørsmål, hva dere synes. Jeg får jo spørre deg her nå i denne ekstrautgaven, hva dere synes om det han, kiropraktoren, sa. Jeg vet ikke. Altså, det å bruke tabletter, det er ikke noe jeg liker. Men jeg tør liksom ikke slutte med det. Jeg gjør ikke det. Men kom gjerne med synspunkter i kommentarfeltet. Og så tenkte jeg at vi skulle se denne her offisielle slagfilmen, den som viser symptomer på slag og sånt. Det var vist den før, men tar det nå. For det er den jeg følger. Han naturmedisiner og han kiropraktoren. Interessant å høre på. Men kan vi stole på han? Jeg vet ikke. Hva synes dere? Her kommer det i hvert fall den offisielle variasjonen.
Versjonen heter det. Ikke variasjonen, ærlig talt. Man snakker skikkelig norsk her. Ja, her ser dere, solen har forsvunnet bakom trærene. Og nå kommer der en video om slag.
Hello, in this health sketch we want to talk to you about stroke. It's a bit of an odd name, stroke. It certainly has nothing to do with tennis strokes, swimming strokes, or brush strokes. The word stroke comes from the idea of receiving a strike or blow, as that is how quickly strokes appear. All of a sudden, people are struck by this illness. Did you know that every year more than 15 million people worldwide have a stroke? Of these, 5 million die and another 5 million are left disabled. Whilst most strokes occur in people over the age of 65, they can occur in much younger people too. But what exactly is a stroke? The brain, like all parts of the body, needs oxygen, which it gets from the blood. A stroke happens when blood flow to the brain is cut off. When brain cells are starved of oxygen, they become damaged, and the symptoms that follow are called a stroke. As the brain controls the whole body, the symptoms of a stroke can be wide-ranging, depending on which parts of the brain are affected. If the stroke occurs here, it would cause a drooping face. Here, weakness in the arms or legs. Or here, difficulty speaking. Other symptoms can happen too, like changes to vision, loss of balance, confusion, and memory loss. The effects might be barely noticeable, but are more often severe and disabling. Sometimes these changes can be reversed if treatment is started early. That's why it is so important to act quickly if you suspect a stroke. Remember, you need to get help fast. F is for face. Is their face drooping on one side? Can they smile? A is for arms. Is there weakness in the arms? Can they lift them both up? S is for speech. Is their speech slurred? T is for time. If you spot any one of these signs, then it's time to call an ambulance. Once the ambulance arrives at the hospital, a doctor will assess you and arrange an urgent scan of the head, which shows where the brain is damaged and what type of stroke has happened. Strokes are put into two groups depending on the problem in the blood vessels supplying the brain. There can either be a blockage, called an ischemic stroke, or a bleed, called a hemorrhagic stroke. The majority of strokes are blockages. It's important to identify early on which sort of stroke has happened, as they each have very different treatments. Blockage strokes are commonly caused by the buildup of fatty material in blood vessels. This fatty buildup may lead to a clot, which blocks the blood supply, just like in a heart attack. This is why a stroke can be thought of as a brain attack. A clot may occur within the brain, or it can travel from another part of the body, commonly the blood vessels in the neck. Clots can also travel from the heart, which may happen when you have an irregular heartbeat called atrial fibrillation, or AF. If a blockage stroke is detected within the first few hours, a clot-busting medication is sometimes given to dissolve the clot. This is called thrombolysis. If thrombolysis can't be used, other medications, such as aspirin, will be given as treatment instead. Bleeding strokes happen when a blood vessel bursts suddenly, causing blood to leak in or around the brain. In these strokes, blood on the brain can lead to swelling, a serious problem which may require surgery in some cases. Sometimes, stroke symptoms completely disappear in less than 24 hours. This is called a mini-stroke, or TIA. Often, symptoms only last a few minutes, but just like with a full-blown stroke, you must go to hospital immediately if you suspect a TIA. This is because a TIA is a warning sign that you're at high risk of having a full stroke. Whether you have a TIA or a full stroke, daily medications are started and continued lifelong to help prevent further episodes. The effects of a stroke can be disabling, but given time, the brain can slowly adapt to recover some previously lost abilities. This is why stroke rehabilitation is so important. Rehab can be challenging, but many specialists are on hand to help alongside doctors and nurses. If your stroke causes difficulty swallowing, dietitians can recommend special diets or feeding tubes. If you have problems with communication, speech and language therapists can help. If it has become difficult to walk or perform daily tasks, physiotherapists and occupational therapists can offer exercises and home adaptations. Also, after a stroke, people often feel low or frustrated that they can't do the things they used to and don't like being dependent on others. Counselors can help talk through these feelings, and many patient groups are available for further support. We've talked a lot about strokes, but what can we do to prevent them from happening? Even if you've already had a stroke in the past, there are many small steps we can all take to reduce our future risk of having a stroke, such as lowering high blood pressure, the number one cause of stroke, stopping smoking, lowering cholesterol, being more active, eating healthily, lowering alcohol intake to within recommended limits. If you have diabetes, keeping good control of blood sugar levels. In this health sketch, we've talked about what a stroke is, how to spot the key symptoms, and the need to act fast. We've also talked about treatments, rehab, and the steps we can take to prevent strokes. We hope this health sketch about stroke has been helpful for you and those around you. Health sketch. Health for all to see.
Unngå for slag. Fortsett å se kaffebloggen. Fortsatt riktig god torsdag.
Han er Abel. Hun er Fabis nå. God kveld. Takk for nå.
Moscow in flames, missiles headed toward New York. Film at 11.
If you don't have any art, you're pretty much lost.
Imagine there's no heaven, nothing to kill or die for, and no religion too.
Film at 11.
Hallo, hallo. I dag tenkte jeg at vi skulle snakke litt om de gule vestene som holder på i Frankrike. De driver jo opptøyer nå på tredje uka mot myndighetene, og media prøver å få oss til å tro at de gjør dette her fordi at de har økt bensinprisen bittelitt. Det som er veldig interessant med dette er jo at både ytterste høyre og ytterste venstre har slått seg sammen for å slåss mot myndighetene. Og det sier at det kanskje kan være noe litt annerledes enn kun en liten endring i bensinprisene som skaper det opptøyene.
Unnskyld.